Hello students, welcome back standard 3rd. Today in session 2 we are going to continue chapter 11, our vehicles. So in this session we will read a story and solve the textual exercise. Children, let's recapitulate the chapter. In session 1, we read about vehicles, means of transport, vehicles with different number of wheels. We also read the poem, The Train, and solved some textual exercise. Let's begin our today's session. Let's meet some children and find out how they spend their vacation. During vacation, all go out of station. Some go nearby, whereas some go far away places. Some of them are going by bus, train, or aeroplane. Journey can be done in many ways. Some children shared their vacation here. Here, the first girl is saying that she went to her uncle's house who lives in Delhi. Earlier, she used to travel by bus from railway station to reach her uncle's house. But this time, she took a metro rail. Students, have you seen a metro rail? This is a metro rail and this is the tunnel. A metro rail runs under the ground through the tunnels and you cannot even see the cars running on roads above the tunnel. In the second picture, you can see the tunnel through which the metro rail runs under the ground. Here, the next boy is telling that he went to his bua's wedding. Bua means father's sister. There, he met many relatives. He had a very good time there. His brother came from America in an aeroplane. Aeroplane is the fastest mode of transportation. It can cover long distances within a very short period of time. It is an air transport. His bua looked very beautiful when she was going in the palki. Students, palki is a covered litter for one passenger consisting of a large box carried on two horizontal poles by 4 or 6 bearers. Here, the girl is saying that she went to her nanny's house in Kerala. Nanny means grandmother. In Kerala, there are many rivers, lakes everywhere. So from station, they could take a bus or a car to reach her house. Instead, they took a boat straight to her house. She felt little strange, but it was fun. Here, the next boy is telling that he went to Shimla during vacations. The bus moved on the zigzag roads on high mountains. Children, here you can see the zigzag roads on the high mountains. It was very scary when they looked down. They had to walk long distances in Shimla. His daddy would get tired very quickly. So they would make her ride on the horse. The boy never got tired. He enjoyed walking. The next girl is saying that her Masi lives very close to her house. So, whenever she wants to go to her Masi's place, she quickly climbs on her cycle. Her mother and Chotu have to take a rickshaw to go to her Masi's house. Here, the boy is saying that he went to his Mamaji's village. From the railway station, there is no bus to go to the village. So, he went in a bullock cart. Students, have you ever ridden on a bullock cart? Well, it moves very slowly, but is fun too. He crossed the lush green fields on the way to the village. Bullocks are having bells tied around their necks. He enjoyed that sound. Now, let's solve the textual exercise. Here, the question says, which all vehicles did the children travel in? According to the story, the following vehicles were used by children while traveling: bus, metro rail, boat, cycle, and bullock cart. Here, the question says, how would you choose to go from your house to the places written below? Write in the box. So let us see what will be the possible answers for this question. Students, here I have mentioned the name of some vehicles that I use to reach in these destinations. I take a scooter to reach market. I ride on my bicycle to reach my friend's house. My nanny lives in America, so I have to take airplane to reach there. I travel on a ship when I have to travel across the sea. I will take a boat to travel across the river. Some of my relatives live in hilly areas, so I travel in a train to reach there. I used to go to school by school bus. So, this is how I managed to go to these destinations. Now, children, ask this question to yourself, that how would you choose to go from your house to the places written below, and write it in the box. Write in front of each picture what the vehicle is used for. In the spaces provided, draw the pictures of some other vehicles. Write their names and what they are used for. Are all these vehicles used for our travel? So students, let us see what will be the possible answers for this question. In the first picture, you can see a hand cart. A hand cart is used by various fruit and vegetable sellers to carry fruits, vegetables, and other articles. The second one is an image of a mail van. A mail van is used for transporting couriers, mails, from one place to another. The third one is an image of a cycle for the disabled. Cycle for the disabled is used by the disabled people or the physically handicapped people to move from one place to another. The fourth one is an image of a tractor. A tractor is used for different agricultural purposes like tilling the field. Here you can see the image of a double-decker bus. A double-decker bus is used to carry passengers from one place to another. Next, you can see the image of an ambulance. An ambulance is used for carrying sick people to the hospital. Here, you can see the image of a fire brigade van. It is used for putting out fires. Next, you can see the image of a sheep. Sheep is used for transporting goods and people. So students, here I have given you the home assignment. Now, you have to write these answers in your EVS notebook. Now, I will stop my today's teaching session over here. I will continue the rest of the chapter in the next sessions. Children, now go through the session, revise it, and also finish your home assignment. Thank you.